Pixel shift on the Sony cameras is a feature where the camera moves the sensor physically. On the R3, it's one pixel, four times. On the R4, it can be up to 16 times a half a pixel. It also allows for a huge file, a massive file. It's essentially four times the size of what you could otherwise get, about a little over 200 megapixels. So just a tremendously large, super sharp, super color accurate file that's gonna be amazing.
Pixel shift technology is essentially the filling in of the gaps that typically happen because of the patterns of the RGB color spectrum that get picked up in the pixel space by these sensors and most of the cameras out there. Now, typically, most of this information is just kind of filled in algorithmically through the processor and the sensor. But with Pixel shift, that information is filled in from actual detail from out there in the field, giving you an image that is much more detailed and has much more texture than normally it's capable of capturing.
Pixel shift is really for specific situations where you have a subject that isn't moving and you can lock down the camera. I've used Pixel shift in the Grand Canyon, Death Valley, places where there's beautiful, amazing landscapes, but without a lot of things that move. So no running water, not a bunch of trees that are blowing in the wind. It's a beautiful, beautiful landscape, and it really lends itself to that because it's so solid and sturdy.
I use Pixel shift technology when I have a client that wants really, really big prints, or when I'm doing something for a campaign that might be used, say, in Times Square. I want to make sure that not only do I have a large resolution final image output, but I want to make sure that I have the most image data possible so that when these things get blown up and when I'm either blowing things up or cropping things in quite a bit, that I retain much more image data.
Another great thing about Pixel shift is the color accuracy. Normally when you take a picture with a digital sensor, each pixel has either a red, a green, or a blue filter over it, and it captures that color information, and then it's put together, and to us, it looks fantastic. But with Pixel shift, you get that red information, that green information, and that blue information at each photo site, at each pixel, so it gives you much more accurate color that's as accurate as it can get. When I use Pixel shift on my camera, I want to get to it quickly, so I have a custom button set to it. On my camera, it's the C4 button, so I just hit the button, the menu comes up, I tell it the delay I want, the delay between images. With the 4, it would be, if I want 4, 16 frames. It's set, I hit go, it just goes.
Ultimately, it gives you, again, a much more detailed image, much more texture, almost medium format-like quality, but also much higher resolution final image output.